Ready?
Yeah.
Cole?
Okay, I'm recording.
Now concentrate, Jodie. Tell me if you feel anything in particular about any of these objects.
See anything, Aiden?
Thank you, Dad. It's so pretty.
Open it.
It was all blurry. I didn't see anything.
Yeah. Nathan? Okay, my turn. Nathan, someone named Ryan Clayton is here to see you. He says you know what it's about.
Yes. I'll be back in a moment. Listen, I never get around to telling her I need more time.
No. Professor Dawkins, she needs to come with me today. I have my orders.
Christ, she's only a child. Sistan and I are the only family she's got. She doesn't have any idea what's out there.
Look, Dawkins, I see your side of it. All right, I do. But orders are orders, right? You gonna bring her to me, or do I have to go and get her?
Jodie, could you come here, please?
What's going on, Nathan? You look upset.
Jodie, this is Ryan Clayton from the CIA. The agency wants you to join their military school program at Camp Perry. Ryan's going to take care of you from now on. You have to go with him, Jodie. Today.
Understand. Why me?
This unit belongs to the CIA. They've been tracking your case ever since you arrived. They know what you and Aiden can do.
I am not a child. I can make my own decisions. No one can force me to go.
Hey, Jodie, I know. It's difficult, but you need to understand. This is a great opportunity for you.
I don't care what you think. I'm not going anywhere.
Jesus, listen up, Miss Holmes. I don't give a shit about your pathetic adolescent pouting, all right? You can rant and rave all you want, but you'll shut your mouth and do as you're told.
Go fuck yourself.
That's it. Let's go. Come here.
Jodie. Jodie, stop immediately.
I'll go get my things.
Only the essentials. We've got everything you need at Camp Perry.
Thank you.
Worry. I'm sure you'll be great. Damn. I'm gonna miss the hell out of you, princess. I'll come and see you as soon as I can. I'll never let you down. You know that, don't you? Be there for you.
Time to go.
Yeah?
Jodie. Hey, it's Ryan.
Ryan!
I was just wondering if you got my email.
What email?
The one I sent 3 days ago.
You know, I've actually been having problems with my computer. What was the email about?
Dinner, tonight, fancy restaurant. Anyway, it's too late now, so... maybe another time?
Shit, I'm so sorry. Why don't you just come over here for dinner tonight? I mean, you wanted to see my apartment anyway, so...
Sure, but I...
How about around 8?
Okay. Yeah, I'll bring a kick-ass bottle of wine. See you later.
Now I get why you blasted my computer. You didn't want me to see Ryan. It's not your call, Aiden. I can do what I want. Fuck this. Fuck this! We're not gonna start this again. I'm not yours, Aiden. I can have a relationship with whoever I want. This is my life. Okay, do you fucking hear me? This is my life. You know what? I happen to think Ryan is great. He's charming, he's intelligent, he's funny. And I think I'm falling for him. Yeah. Yeah, I'm aware of what happened at the bar. Fuck you for reminding me. Ryan is not like that. Okay. Okay. It's 7:00. I have an hour to make dinner, tidy up, and make my... myself look good. The trash can in the kitchen. Books. Okay, on the bookshelf. Okay, great. Oh my God. God, the dinner! Okay, there's gotta be something in the kitchen. I gotta find something I can make in 1 hour with what's ever left in the fridge. Asian beef, oh, I mean, that looks good. It's not too complicated. Curried chicken with oven-baked vegetables. It'll take some time in the oven, but it seems doable. Pizza delivery. I mean, it's not exactly gourmet, but no preparation, no mess. I mean, it could be an option. Pizza. I mean, it's the easy way out, but he's not gonna mind. Yeah, I'll call them. You know, you're wasting your time, Aiden. You're not gonna stop me from seeing Ryan. Oh, good God, I know the number by heart. Hey, yeah, could I get a large pizza? The, Super Supreme? Like 8, 8:15. Yeah. 6192 Columbus Street. Yeah, the 9th floor. Okay, cool. Great, thanks. Too proud of myself, but at least we're gonna eat. All right, dirty clothes in the basket in the bathroom. All right, there. Crap. Crap. I've got to change. What should I wear? Oh, hi, Ryan. I've been waiting for you. I don't know. Oh, hey, Ryan. Yeah, whatever. I just, like, threw these old things on, because... Yeah, I'm cool. I'm cool. Is it not enough effort? Oh, hello, Ryan. Oh, do you like it? Classic, elegant. Je ne sais quoi. Classy. It's the new me, and it shows that I can adapt to any situation. You might as well just give up, Aiden. Okay? This date is going on. Period. Coming! Oh, good one, Aiden. Okay, you got me. Now, open the door. Aiden! Aiden, come on, open up! Games? I can play too. Ugh. Ugh, God. Ugh, I hate this stuff.
I didn't behave yourself. This is important to me, and I'm counting on you.
Chateau Margaux, 2001. The guy in the store said it was a pretty good year.
That sounds good to me, so. Why don't you sit? I'll get the thing that opens the wine.
Cool apartment.
Huh? Yeah, thanks. For fuck's sakes!
You want me to open it?
No, I'll do it.
To your new apartment.
To my new apartment.
Oh, so when did you move in?
A couple weeks ago. Yeah, the agency found it for me and all furnished and everything. It's actually the first place I've ever had just by myself. So it's weird getting used to the idea. And how about you? Where do you live?
Oh, I have a place just outside of town. That's small.
Did you grow up here? Or?
No, I was born in Oregon.
It's nothing. It's just Aiden's messing with us. Ignore him. Keep the change.
Thanks.
I ordered pizza. I hope that's...
No, pizza's good. Don't sweat it. So we've been working together now for what, 2 years? I mean, almost nothing about you. Your parents, do you, still see them? Okay. Are you sure everything's okay?
Yes, everything's fine. Aiden is just... He's just feeling a little nervous. It's okay, really.
Yeah, did Nathan ever manage to explain to you why you have this link with Aiden?
No.
I think there's something wrong with Aiden.
Give me a second. I'm fed up with you and your goddamn jealousy.
So why don't you just go back to whatever ethereal fucking place you came from and let me get on with my life? Get out of here! Do you fucking hear me? Get the fuck out!
It's like, is he here now? Listening to us?
Yeah. Yeah, he never leaves me.
What about you? Do you have any family here?
No, my parents are still in Oregon. Go to see them as little as possible. Iden's not happy with me being here.
I don't give a damn how Iden feels.
And are you married or anything?
No. Yes, I mean, I...
Fuck, Iden! I need you to just stop!
Listen, I better go.
No, Ryan, wait. No,
Jodie, look, Iden's very possessive. I think you gotta work it out with him. Jodie, look, we don't need to rush it. Hey, let's just take some time to get to know each other. Maybe I didn't wind up being okay with that.
Are you happy now? You get what you wanted. He's gone, and now you have me to yourself. I really hope you're deliriously fucking happy. Why don't you just float around in your invisible world and watch me cry? I hate you! Do you hear me? I fucking hate you!
Nathan, I'm so tired. Can we go now?
Oh, jeez. Is that what time it is? I'm sorry. I was concentrating on my work. I know you've had a long day. Hey, this morning I bought your book. What do you say we get you tucked in and I read to you?
Yes, please.
I must have left it in the other room. Why don't you go in there and get it? I'll finish up here, and then we can go, okay?
Sure, I'm on it. So, where did he leave that book? Stop it, Iden. It's not funny.
Thank you. you found it. Now we can get down to the serious business of bedtime stories.
Jodie? Jodie, you okay? You look pale.
She looks dead tired is how she looks. Come on, Nathan, let's get her off to bed. Yes. Yes, hold on. Nathan, it's for you.
Nathan Dawkins.
Nathan, what's up?
My wife ordered, they were coming back from my mother's truck. Drunk driver, wrong side of the road. Dead?
Jodie, let's get you off to bed. Hey, stay right here. I'll be right back. Come on, Jodie. Like it, Jodie. No guard on gate. Empty parking lot. Something doesn't feel right.
I'm not back in 30 minutes. Just go.
Girl, I didn't come here to wait in no car.
Cole, wait.
Come to see Nora Gray?
Can I see your authorization?
Authorization? God, I knew I forgot something.
I'm sorry. All visitors must have the correct authorization.
Okay, so it didn't get him this time. What next?
I'm working on it.
I was afraid you'd say that.
Found her. Nora Gray, 7th floor, room 43.
Hey, there's no call button. Maybe it's behind the desk. So far, so good.
Huh?
What now?
Aiden, find a way to open that door. First, have a look around. Nice, Aiden. Now unlock the door. Come on. Far away.
Are you willing to sacrifice your life to save this crazy world, Jodie?
Him here, Aiden.
Jesus. Crazy folk really freaked me out. Can we find room 43 and get the hell out of here? I'll wait here. Jodie, she may have lost her mind. She might not even know you're there. Maybe you shouldn't go in.
Thank you. Help me, Aiden.
You won't be able to, Nora. Let us take care of everything. It's for the best. You know that.
That's my baby! Bring her back! I changed my mind! I want her baby!
Sedate her quickly.
Please!
Get the baby out of here!
I want to see her! Please, please let me see her! I want my child! Please!
She may develop some special abilities. Let us know as soon as anything unusual happens. Increase the dose. Make sure she never regains consciousness.
Sorry. I'm sorry. It was my fault. What are you trying to show me? Destroy this thing, Aiden. Destroy it now! My little girl. Never see you again. I've missed you so much, Jodie. I've missed you so much. What happened? What did they do to you? The drugs they gave me trapped me in this hell. There's nothing I can do. Just wait for it to end. I'm gonna get you out of here. I'm gonna help you. It's too late, Jodie. It's too late. I love you more than anything else in the world. Nothing will ever change that.
I'm sorry, Jodie.
most powerful condenser ever created. Impressive, isn't it?
Nathan.
Oh. Jodie, it's good to see you. I was so afraid something happened to you. You've lost weight. You look exhausted. But at least you're alive. Let's go into my office. Please, have a seat. How do you feel?
I've been better. That hit on the head did not help.
Oh, I'm sorry. I told them not to hurt you. I just didn't want to give you a chance to use Aiden.
How did they find me?
They've been tracking you ever since you escaped. They wanted to kill you. But I convinced them to wait for a while and watch you from a distance.
What happened to my mother, Nathan?
Nora was unstable. They were afraid she was a danger to herself and her baby.
My mother would never hurt me.
They couldn't take that chance. Look, I was a researcher at the DPA, Jodie. I didn't discover until much later what happened.
Why did you never tell me about my mother? Why did you hide the truth all these years?
I tried to tell you. But how do you tell a little girl that her life isn't real? So, I looked after you. Loved you. Tried to protect you as best as I could.
So now what? You're just gonna hand me back to the CIA? Is that the plan, Nathan?
They brought you here because they have something for you to do, and they'd be very grateful if you do it.
Help them? You want me to help the people that took away my mother and stole my life? I mean, haven't I done enough?
We know another country has discovered the infra-world. They think it's something to be controlled or manipulated. They have no idea what they're dealing with. If entities enter our world, do you know what that would mean, Jodie?
What has all this got to do with me?
Because you know the infra-world better than anyone.
It's the CIA's job. And I'm done with that.
They want to offer you a deal. You do this for them. And they let you out, you're free. Jodie, do you know what would happen if a passage is open? It'll be the apocalypse. You have the power to stop this.
According to our intel, the Republic of Kazakhstan has discovered the existence of the infra-world. Found a rift, conducting experiments from a secret base located in the province of Heilongjiang.
We don't know what stage they are in their experiments, but we've detected important fluctuations within the infra-world. That means they've found a way to interact with the other side.
Now your mission is to destroy this condenser and any other advanced technology you find.
Even if we manage to destroy the condenser, the rift will still be there.
Building a condenser is a costly and time-consuming business. But this operation will gain time to better understand the infra-world and make sure that no one will try to use it against us.
I assume the site will be heavily guarded?
Well, you should expect considerable military resistance. Team will...
Team?
Show them in, Marla.
Oh, Hey, baby.
Good to see you, girl.
Clayton's team goes with you, a small, agile commando unit able to avoid detection. The mission begins in 2 days. Good luck.
Be careful, Jodie. No one knows what you're gonna find on the other side.
Don't worry. I don't think I'm ready to join the info world yet.
Good. Because I don't want to lose you.
It's good to see you.
Fuck you, Ryan.
So you're still angry, then?
You really think that you can just come back here and pretend like nothing happened?
Jodie, I...
Shh. Don't talk, so you won't have to lie.
Right.
I grow tired of all this. If you refuse to cooperate, I will have no choice but to kill you. Of course, I will kill you regardless. But it could have been fast and painless. Instead, it will be a very, very slow and agonizing death. So, I ask you one last time. Who do you work for?
Where are you?
It's completely deserted!
You sure it's here?
We're right on top of the coordinates.
Storm's getting worse! What do we do now?
Jodie, ask Aiden to find a shelter somewhere.
You hear that, Aiden?
Got it! Let's go!
What are we doing here?
It's just a goddamn fishing village.
Our informer duped us. That's what happened. We better get moving before they have to dig our frozen dead asses out of here.
3 days, walking on ice, eating snow, for nothing. Fuck! Find the asshole that sent us here.
Hey! I'm sick and tired of hearing you complaining. That's all you have to say, then shut the fuck up!
Guys, I'm freezing. You think maybe we could build a fire first and argue later?
She's right. We'll set up camp here till the storm blows over. I'll contact HQ and get instructions.
Everything's wet.
Let me try. Damn. All this stuff is soaking.
You better find something. We won't make it to the house.
Did you get a connection?
No, it's gonna take some time with the storm. You're still angry with me, huh? Look, it probably won't make you change your mind, but I regret what happened.
You're right. It doesn't make me change my mind. I'm gonna go out. I'm desperate for a pee.
Don't go too far, okay?
It's minus 40. I don't plan on doing any sightseeing.
On
the main road. A convoy of armored cars. They drove right by me.
Did they see you?
No. No, I don't think so.
Let's roll. Let's follow them! Bingo.
I didn't go see what's inside. soldiers. They're loading crates into submarines.
Submarines? That means the rift is...
I mean, they must have a base down there, and they're using the subs to shuttle supplies.
How many soldiers?
I can see three.
Tell Aiden to take them out.
Aiden? Get rid of them. Wait. Get rid of the soldiers first.
Sorry.
You could give me some warning.
So, what do we do now?
Just give me a second, okay?
Feels like we missed something.
What exactly are you doing?
I'm finding a solution to the problem.
Nice idea, but it won't fool them very long.
Yeah, well, maybe not. But that fucking rift is not gonna shut down by itself, is it?
Okay. That might work from a distance. Then what?
Take the sub down to the base, and then we take it from there.
I'll go with her.
What about us?
It's a two-seater. You stay here, you find us a way out. By the time we get back, there's a good chance we're gonna have to move fast.
What?
Wait, that's an order, Nick. Give me the explosives.
You do realize we might not make it back alive, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I've known that from the start.
Keep keep diving. The base shouldn't be far.
Visibility's bad. It's hard to get my bearings.
See the lights?
I hope that wasn't a question.
I am impressed. Few men would have heard that for so long. Perhaps you will be more sensitive to your comrade's pain. My questions are simple. I want to know your name, who you work for, and how you learn of the existence of this base. Of course, you also have to tell me what happened when you crossed the containment field.
Say nothing, you hear me?
My name is Holmes.
Jodie, no.
Jodie Holmes. Agent 894732. I work with the CIA.
So the CIA is aware of our little experiments. And what about the entity that was trapped in our containment field?
He's tied to me. I was born with him.
Fascinating. The Americans have also discovered the existence of this phenomenon. I must inform my superiors. I will return soon to continue our conversation.
Sorry, Ryan.
Now what?
We find the condenser, destroy it, and get out.
And any idea how you plan to do that?
No. But I'll figure something out.
Chance.
don't get too close to them.
We can't just wait here.
Ni, 过来. 封杀你的武器!
Aiden, I need you.
Are you Aiden? Hide in your bag. Hurry. Find me. Subs, wait for me. If I'm not back in 15 minutes, just go without me.
You crazy? Look, Jodie, we've done it. The base is destroyed. Let's get out of here while we still can.
The rift is wide open. Entities are just gonna come pouring out if we don't close it.
No, it's too late, Jodie. We gotta go now.
It's the only way. You know that. The explosives. I need the explosives in the interrogation room.
really scared. I didn't... Stay close, okay? Light on this thing. Keep calm, Biden.
You're going to die here with me. The greatest discovery the world has ever known. Destroyed because of you, stupid American bitch! Years of work! All for nothing!
Ah!
pay for what you've done!
Come on, Jodie. Come back to me. Huh? Come back. Oh, fuck. Come on, Jodie. Don't die, huh? Don't die. Don't die.
Good night, Princess.
Is Nathan okay? When will I see him again?
Oh. I don't know, honey. He hasn't left his office in 3 days. He loved his wife and daughter more than anything in the world. But we can try again tomorrow, okay? Get some sleep.
Jodie. What are you doing here? It's late. Go back to bed. What did you say?
It was so quick. Mommy couldn't do anything. But it didn't hurt.
Stop it, Jodie.
It didn't hurt at all.
You hear me? Stop it right now.
We're here, Nathan. We're right by your side.
Helen. Laura.
We love you, darling. We'll always love you.
Talk to me again. Jodie. Make them come back. Make them come back again!
I can't. They've gone.
Please. Don't leave me. Don't leave me. I miss them so much.
The active condenser in the Republic of Kazakhstan has been destroyed and the rift is now inaccessible. We are now the only nation with access to the infoworld. This situation opens up new strategic and military perspectives. Now we're going to launch new programs to discover possible energy resources and develop military applications. We've already found ways of linking entities to human soldiers, and this is just the beginning. Now, this is more important than the race to space or developing nuclear capability. We have discovered a new world. A world for us to conquer. This is the beginning of a new era for our nation.
Pentagon top brass getting you down?
Ugh. Big boys and their new toys. I preferred to leave before barfing all over their carpet.
Yeah, we played our part in all of this.
They told us we were doing the right thing. But all we did was allow the Pentagon alone to control the infra-world.
What are you gonna do now?
Maybe I'll go back to the people I like. And the people who like me for who I truly am. I haven't met too many along the way. And what about you?
CIA has it all mapped out for me. Top tier, big car, golf meetings. I mean, I haven't given them an answer yet, but it's worth considering. Listen, Jodie, I know it's been complicated between us, and I didn't always do the right thing. But maybe we could start again. You know, try and build something together. I mean, after all the stuff we've been through, maybe we could make it work.
It's worth a try.
I will do whatever it takes to make you happy. And you'll forget about all this.
Ah, there you are. Nathan's looking for you. Come on, I'll take you to his office. Later, Ryan. Oh, you know what? I got a single malt in my office that needs sharing. Meet you in a few?
Never say no to a single malt.
Great. I see you in a bit. Let's go, Jody. Nathan's waiting. Ryan's a good guy, and I think he really cares about you.
Yeah. I just hope that Aiden was gonna get that too.
Alright, here we are. Call me when you're done, I'll come pick you up.
Okay.
Whatever Nathan says, be careful.
Come in!
Jody. Oh, I'm so glad to see you safe.
I kept my part of the bargain. Now it's the CIA's turn.
As far as the CIA is concerned, you no longer exist. You're now Elizabeth North. No identity and no life. $500,000 for services rendered. That should help make a new start.
Thanks.
Before you go, there's one last thing I'd like to ask. When my wife and daughter disappeared in that accident 15 years ago, I wanted to die too. I cried a lot, banging my head against the wall, trying to figure out why them? Never being able to hold them again. It was like a wound that wouldn't heal. But then you came along. And I realized
They were still here all the time, near me. I just couldn't see.
Gave me everything I needed to study the infra-world. They were interested in military applications. I was interested in seeing my family again. It's taken me some years, but I finally succeeded in creating this. Hello, my darlings. You so much. I come to see them every day. Soon we'll be together. I'm working on a modified condenser that can communicate with souls of the infra-world. Speaking with the dead, Jodie, can you imagine?
What do you want from me?
I want you to help me talk to them. I want to tell them what I'm doing. Until I finish my research, you're the only one that can do it.
Give me your hands.
Nathan, you're hurting us. You've got to let us go. Let us die!
You're lying. Helen didn't say that, you did.
You're keeping them here. They're being torn apart between two roles.
That's not true. You're lying. I know they want to be with me again. I know they want to be with me.
Nathan, I know how you feel.
You know nothing about how I feel! You hear me? Nothing!
Goodbye, Nathan. I hope you find peace.
Hi, Jodie. Good to see you again. Well, you put us in a very difficult situation, you know that. We can't let you go.
We can't kill you either. We don't know what you'll do on the other side. So does any one appropriate solution. We inject you with a neuroacid, which will put you in a permanent coma. Exactly what we did with your mother. A simple and elegant way to put an end to our collaboration. Goodbye, Johnny. We will always be grateful for your help.
But I didn't want to see.
Help me, Nathan.
I'm going to accomplish man's oldest dream. Nobody will have to die anymore. No one will ever be separated again.
What are you talking about?
The containment field. I'm going to deactivate it. The infraworld will spread through our dimension. Life and death united in one world. Death, Jodie. Everything's gonna be just fine. You need to trust me. Everything is gonna turn out fine.
Weak, Aiden. Find something else. Get help. Hurry.
Where's the rest of your team?
Vince and Nick?
They have 3 months leave.
They're on a beach on some exotic island, no doubt.
Lucky bastards. Hey, I've got a couple of emails I need to send. You mind if I do that before we crack the bottle?
No problem.
Okay.
You keep entities in this lab?
Good God, no. They're all trapped behind the containment field.
Aiden? Is that you, Aiden? This is a joke, it's not funny. What is it, Aiden? Where's Jodie? Lead us to Jodie, Aiden. Show us the way.
Now where? This way.
Over there.
Okay, I get it.
Something moved.
Right. Now where? You want us to take the elevator? Is that it?
Freeman, I have level 3 authorization. He's with me.
I'm sorry, Mr. Freeman. You do not have the correct authorization for this level.
Maybe you could make an exception. I just want to show him.
Sorry, sir. This area is level 4 classified. You do not have the right credentials.
You gotta get us past him, Iden.
Desk 42, hello. Hello? Hello?
I think you made a mistake. Could you check again, please? Cole Freeman and Ryan Clayton?
I'm sorry. You are on the list. My apologies. Go on through.
Thank you.
Hurry, Iden. Take us to Jodie.
This way.
Here. There.
Jodie's here? Jodie!
Get out. Oh, Nathan. He's gonna deactivate the containment field.
What? Why? Why would he do that?
He's gone insane. He thinks he's gonna get his family back. We gotta stop him.
Containment field. Oh, Christ, he's done it. He's done it! You need help?
No. No, I'm okay.
This way! Hurry up!
No.
Don't stay here! We gotta move! We gotta come back! Now!
There might still be a chance to reactivate the field. It isn't already too late.
Jesus! They're out! They're all out!
We can't hold them back! God!
Jodie! You're the only one who can stop this! Dawkins has gone mad! He took down the field! You gotta get rid of these goddamn monsters now!
I ought to kill you, McGrath. But the last thing the Infraworld needs is a son of a bitch like you. Get out of my way.
Clayton! Get me out of here immediately, Clayton! Agent Clayton, that's an order!
Consider that my resignation.
You're all gonna die here. We're all gonna die.
Reactivate the field.
There's nothing we can do.
Let's get out of here while we still can.
Wait. There's one more thing I can try.
Hurry! We're out of time!
What are you doing?
It's a portable containment field. It should protect me long enough to reach the condenser and trigger the manual self-destruct. Might be our only chance to close the rift. It's a long shot, but it's the best I got.
Come on, you're talking crazy, Cole. We need to get out of here, let the military clean up their own fucking mess. Jodie, no.
Cole's right. It's our only chance.
Containment field shut down. This is not a drill. Please exit the
drill. Right? I always figured I'd die a hero.
Ever been before, so there's no telling what we'll find down there.
How much time do we have after we've activated the self-destruct?
The system was designed to be activated remotely. The explosion will be practically instantaneous. We're not coming back. The zone is on the other side of that door.
We've got company.
Well, they haven't seen us yet. It's our only chance.
Jesus. I hope you're right. Or our little trip into the info world might come to a sticky end.
Jodie, don't get too close to that.
See us! Run!
fuck?
Jodie, they're coming!
No! No! Cole! No!
There's nothing you can do, Jodie.
I should have gone to him. Fuck, I could have saved him. I could have saved him.
We gotta get out of here.
This. Ryan, no, no, no. No.
We know there's no going back, right?
No, please. Please don't die. Don't die.
You sure this is not the end?
I love you.
I missed you. I missed you so much. You're the only one who can fix this, Jodie.
Do it. Do it for me.
Inject you with a neural acid, which will put you in a permanent coma. Exactly what we did with your mother.
It's too late, Jodie. It's too late.
Farci sale, ma tanti anni che sacrificaci.
I'm sick and tired of your stories! Jodie, this time you're really gonna get it!
Give me back my child!
Calm down, Nora!
I wanna see her! My little girl! My little boy!
For God's sake, what's going on?
The twin! He strangled him. We couldn't do
my
anything.
My son! I want to see my son. Aiden. My twin. My brother. Stillborn. We couldn't leave each other. Our souls were bound together. I loved you and hated you for years. You were a part of me.
Side. Another world. Becoming the wind, the stars, the universe. Being with Aiden and those I've loved forever. Living, feeling, being in love. Growing old. So many things I still have to do. Iden? 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 Iden! Ever since the Black Sun was destroyed, my memory has been disintegrating. I spent too much time on the other side. Now it's eating away at my mind, erasing what's left of it. My memories are all confused, slowly self-destructing, fading like a dream when you wake up. I'm losing my sense of time. I no longer know what happened before or after. Everything's playing inside my head at the same time. It's like watching the same film looping over and over again. A chaos of images with no order. So I've been writing night and day for weeks, trying to put my life down on paper. If I forget everything, these pages will be my memory.
3 months after the fact, the investigation continues in an effort to determine the cause of the accident that cost 283 lives on a Pentagon military base. Government representatives confirm that the authorities are working hand in hand with the investigators to shed light on this appalling tragedy.
The CIA is leaving me alone for the moment. I suppose they're too busy building another condenser to worry about me. I know they'll never abandon their experiments, now that they know what's on the other side. Honestly, I don't give a damn. Now I need to reconstruct my life. My life without Iden. For as long as I can remember, I dreamt of living without him. Untied, without his constant presence by my side. I got what I wanted. I've never been so unhappy in my life. I feel like part of me has been amputated. Crying all day. I know it's stupid. Shit. I miss him so much. Iden is not the only one I miss. Now that Ryan's gone, I realize how much I loved him. I understand how Nathan must have felt. Nothing is worse than knowing you'll never hold someone in your arms again. It took months. silence of nothing passing by. Then I woke up. I knew it was time. Time to start again. To build a new life. It was so obvious. Deep inside, I always knew. I just needed the silence around me to hear what I was feeling. They took me in when I was alone, when all I could think of was dying. They shared the little they had without knowing me or judging me. Deep down, I knew that my place was there. With them.
Look at that. Walter, get in here. Come here. Come here.
Stan does odd jobs here and there.
Oh my God.
Tuesday works behind a bar, and Walter looks after little Zoe.
Looking like a dream girl.
They're not rolling in money, but
you're beautiful.
They manage. I never told them about my past, and they never asked. They love me for who I am. Just some weird chick who talks to spirits. Zoe took to me like we'd always known each other. There's something about her big, sad eyes that reminds me of the little girl I once was. I knew she was different from the moment I saw her. We haven't talked about it, but we both know we have something in common. I see things at night. Terrifying things. I tell myself it's only nightmares, but I know it's not true. The only one who can save the world is a little girl. I have to prepare her. I know I don't have much time. Once Pandora's box is open, it can never be closed again. No. It's not nightmares. It's what is about to happen.
I'm afraid I lost. There's no telling what we'll find out.
How much time do we have after we activate the self-destruct?
We're not coming back.